So today is really a history-shifting day for the Los Angeles Lakers. And I think anytime you have a landmark event where you have an opportunity to introduce the most dominant young basketball player in the world as a member of a Los Angeles Lakers, you have a lot of people to thank as part of the journey in getting here. So I just wanted to start today really with the gratitude and thanking the people behind this, starting with Jeannie Buss, our leader. She is the strongest and most wise leader that I've been around in my life, and we're just so grateful for her and her conviction to lead to a transaction like this. I want to thank Tim Harris for just the integrity he brings to always thinking about the Lakers brand and making sure we do things to uphold that integrity. I'd also like to thank, got a list of people here, so I want to thank Magic too, just for the goal he set for this franchise about 2 years ago to getting to a place where we had two superstars on our roster. And I think that box is checked today with two of the top five players in all of basketball on our Los Angeles Lakers roster. I want to thank Kurt and Linda Rambis too for the support they give, and really everybody in our basketball front office. It's been great working together around a transaction like this. I had lunch about 3 months ago with Jeannie Buss, and it was a special moment. He had called me out of the blue to get together and just shared a whole bunch of things about the pillars of the Buss family and what the Lakers franchise stands for. And that was a key moment for me in getting to today as well, so I wanted to thank him. Anthony has an unbelievable support team around him. Rich Paul, Mark Termini, Farah, just working with them day to day, their excellence and professionalism is so appreciated by us. I want to thank the Pelicans front office, Dave Griffin and Trajan Langdon. Relationships in this business are everything, and I had an opportunity when I was a player representative to have multiple dealings with Dave Griffin when he was with the Cavaliers. Players I represented like Channing Frye and Dion Waiters were on his team. He carries himself with the utmost professionalism, and I want to thank him for how he handled the dealings. And then Trajan Langdon, their general manager, I co-represented him with Arn Tellem when I was an agent. And again, just the relationship fabric there, I think, helped work through the complications of any transaction for a superstar. Wanted to thank both those guys. And I guess lastly, I want to thank Lonzo Ball and Brandon Ingram and Josh Hart. Anytime in this business you make a trade for extraordinary value, you have to give up extraordinary value. And that's how we feel about those three players. And we certainly wish them all the best of luck. So thanks for allowing me the time to thank all those people. What we think about Anthony Davis is this: there is no more complete basketball player in the game. There is nothing he can't do. He can shoot, he can make plays, he can defend 1-5, he can protect the rim, he can handle the ball. His dedication to his craft is unparalleled. And to sit here next to him and think he's going to be on our team and he's going to be a pillar in this franchise for many years is just something we're incredibly proud of. Not just for what he brings as a basketball player, but who he is as a person. He's a person of excellence, and he's a person that carries himself in a way where actions speak louder than words. His craft is on the court and dominance on the court. He's not out talking a lot. You don't see him talking much in games or really talking about himself. He just does it with his work. And that's at the core of how we want this team to be this season. And so it's not only his basketball skills, but who he is as a person that makes us so proud today to introduce Anthony Davis as a member of the Los Angeles Lakers.
Yeah, Anthony, Jim Hill from CBS2 and KKL9. First of all, congratulations and good luck. seems like we've been talking about you coming here for months and months now. How relieved are you that it is finally over? And what was the most difficult part of this process for you?
Thank you. I think the most difficult part for me was just not knowing, the unknown. You know, it was whether, I get traded or whether, I go back to New Orleans. So I think the unknown was just the most difficult for me. And then when, it was announced that I was being traded, I won't say it was a sign of relief. It was just, something that, that I've thought about for a long time. Obviously, it was tough for me to, leave a city that I've been playing for 7 years, but I think it was, best for me, and it was my time. But when I found out I was getting traded to the Lakers, I realized it was an unbelievable opportunity for me to be here with a wonderful organization, and then get to play alongside, LeBron, and obviously now the players that we have now. But back then, before, it was really just LeBron here. To get the opportunity to do that, and come here and play for an organization that's all about winning, winning championships, and that's the only goal. I think that was the biggest thing for me, just the relief there of not knowing the unknown anymore and knowing where I was going to be next season.
Hey, Anthony, Mike Trudell with the Lakers and Spectrum. Just wondered how you think that playing alongside LeBron on offense and defense is going to impact your game, just having somebody that's along that same level of skill. And then I also wondered, Coach Vogel, if you could address that as well.
The things you do on the floor, is pretty amazing. You see it on TV, and when you're a fan of the game, you watch it a lot. And I never really had a chance to experience, playing alongside him. 2012 Olympics, I didn't play as much. I was like the towel guy, just waving towels. We had a little bit of time doing All-Star games, but to get a full season and to see the things that he's able to do, pass, shoot, talks well defensively, he's a great leader. I'm excited to, get a lot of that, this season and just go from there.
Yeah, and I would say that if you were the towel guy, they were misusing you. I don't care how old you were.
I was 18 then, yeah.
In terms of the two of them complementing each other, both are guys that are going to command double teams in any action that you put them in. They're going to draw a lot of attention. So to have a second star to be the counterpunch to each other is really just going to, have the two of them complement each other.
Anthony, you've been seen in cameras kind of talking with LeBron over the last couple months and gone to dinner with him. And I was just kind of curious, over the last few months, how has that relationship evolved? And was there any sort of words or advice that kind of carried you through the last couple months where you had a lot of uncertainty from him?
A lot of people before the trade happened, speculated that I was coming to the Lakers just because we had dinner. Me and LeBron are close friends, and a lot of people and players in the league are really close with each other off the court. And obviously, if I live here in the summer and, he's available, we players tend to go to dinner. And so it was a lot of speculation there. But when it happened, obviously we were both excited. We haven't really talked much about, the team as much. But I know, it's definitely going to get talked about and try to do whatever we can possible to make this team, a championship team next season. Well, this season.
Hey, Anthony. Dave McMenamin, ESPN. With all the moves that have happened since you've been traded to the Lakers, it seems like the league is in an arms race. How do you stack up your team against what everything's happening in the league right now?
It's going to be fun. It's going to be fun for sure. I'm excited about it. I think the league has grown. I think it's better. All the players, teaming up and spreading that talent throughout the league. It's going to be a fun season. I like our roster. I like every player that we have. From 1 through 14. So I'm excited about it, and you know, I'll put our roster up against anybody. I feel like that, you know, in the 7-game series that we'll come out victorious.
Yeah, Anthony, Bill Plaschke, Los Angeles Times. How are you seeing a long-term commitment to this club? Are you prepared to make a long-term commitment here? How do you view your time here and in your what is your purpose?
I haven't had much time here, to be honest, but honestly, I'm focused on the season. When I got traded here, my goal is to bring a championship here, you know, with the team that we have. And, you know, when that time comes around next year, then you can ask me that question and we revisit it. But right now, you know, my focus is on this year and trying to figure out how I can help this team and, you know, help this organization become a championship team.
Brad Turner, LA Times. Rob, I was just wondering, when you guys were not able to get a deal done back in February, how difficult or challenging was it for you, the organization, to stay the course and not give up on trying to make this trade?
It's a great question, Brad. I think, again, it kind of goes back to the people involved. I think, you know, Gail Benson was involved, and we appreciate that she just kept an open mind to do what was best for both transactions, for both the best transaction for both organizations. You know, and Jeannie's, her recommendation was, we always want to give value for value when it comes to a trade. It's just, that's how partners operate. And I think when we approached it that way with Mrs. Benson, and then with the relationships I had with David Griffin and Trajan Langdon in particular, I think it just set a new path and a new course to get something done. It was a very professional, open dialogue. These things are never easy. I think for superstars to get traded, there's lots of complications that you have to work through. It's just part of deal making. But with Jeannie's support, with Gail Benson's support, and then working with Trajan Langdon, Dave Griffin, and myself, we were able to come together as a circle and get it done, and we're really excited.
Tanya Ganguly from the LA Times. What were you doing when you heard that, when you were told that it finally went through and you were going to be a Laker?
I was actually in Malibu, and I was, I don't know the name of the hotel, I don't know how to pronounce it, the one right next to Nobu. I was at that hotel. and I was watching a movie, laying in bed watching a movie, and my agent called me. And, you know, in the middle of a movie, I don't really like to answer phones and text, so I was like, I'll call him later. Then he called me again, so I did kind of like hit it, like, all right. And then I was like, wait, let me call him back. So when I called him back, it went straight to voicemail. So as me being a 26-year-old, I went straight to Instagram, just started looking, and that's when I saw it. And I was like, oh, and I'm blowing his phone up now, and, you know, we finally talked and just kind of, you know, figure out what happened, and he was telling me what was going on. So, yeah, that's what was going on. Huh?
What movie were you watching?
I don't even remember. It was like a blur. It just all happened so fast, you know. I can't even think of the name of it. It was like some sailor movie or something like that. So, I don't know why it was on, but it was pretty interesting.
Hey, Anthony and Frank, Om Young, ESPN. I was wondering, the Lakers made sure to keep Kyle Kuzma and not trade him in that package for you. I was wondering, what do you see in Kyle Kuzma? Do you think he can kind of be that third guy with you and LeBron? And Frank, I was wondering, what have you seen in Kuzma this summer?
Kuzma's an unbelievable player, you know, a young player who's steadily growing, always working on his craft. You know, anytime I played against him, it was always great battles. You can shoot it, you can stretch the floor, you can put it down, you can finish. Got some post moves, so I'm very excited about playing alongside him.
And Kuz, I couldn't be more impressed with in all aspects. Everything he's able to do on the basketball court, you know, I'm going to push him to you know, really reach his potential on the defensive end. We know he can fill it up and score in every way imaginable. And, you know, he's shown to me very early on that, you know, he's very, very coachable. His attitude is a 10 out of 10. He's a team first guy. And, you know, he's going to be a major factor for us, going to play a major role for us.
Anthony, ESPN LA and The Athletic, Andy Kamenetsky. I was wondering if you and LeBron have either talked about or if you've just started imagining the leadership dynamic between you guys and how you think it's going to play out as you guys lead this team.
No, we haven't talked about it, but I think that's something that just happens natural. I don't think you talk about, I'm going to be a leader, you're going to be a leader. I think it just happens. And it can happen, not just me and LeBron, it can happen with anybody. You know, I think any player on a team, can step up and say whatever to another player, coach, whatever, if we're all family trying to reach the same goal. Guys going to challenge each other. There's going to be times where LeBron challenged me, I challenged him, and, so on and so forth with the rest of the players on the team. But it just doesn't have to be, Rondo's an excellent leader. So you have other guys on the team who can lead as well. And I think, 1 through 14, guys are, more than welcome to challenge other players and to better the team.
Anthony, back here. Dylan Hernandez of the LA Times. Obviously, a lot of times it's kind of a circusy like atmosphere around this team. There were a lot of reports about just kind of dysfunction in the front office and that kind of stuff. And I was wondering, did you have any reservations about coming here? And if not, why not? And what has LeBron kind of told you about what the culture is like here?
We haven't even talked about it. And, that's not my concern. I wasn't here last year when they were saying this and that. It wasn't my problem. I'm here now. I haven't seen any of it. And so I'm happy to get started, take this season head on with the goal of winning the championship.
Kyle Goon, Orange County Register. Anthony, what went into the decision to waive your trade kicker?
Obviously, anytime you're able to acquire a player like Kawhi, I think you have to do almost everything to, get a guy like that. Obviously, it didn't work out for us, but, I still wanted to make sure I did whatever to help the team. That $4 million was to, add more money to a player's contract that they wanted or, get another guy, then by all means, I was willing to do that. And I think we did a great job of using that, throughout the entire team.
I'll just add to that. I mean, it was an incredibly team-focused, sacrificial move by Anthony. But and I alluded to this yesterday on the conference call, when he made that move, we had the space that we had. He can attest to this, but he and I and LeBron talked so much about, hey, how do we want to optimize that space? And we saw there were sort of two routes to do it. One is to get a third star, but the other is to take that depth route and build a really deep, versatile roster. And I think the collaboration, I mean, how many calls do we have between me, you, and LeBron?
Every day, on the hour.
Yeah, on the hour, just making sure that when he made that sacrifice, that really every dollar would be used in a way that he felt good about. And so I think that was a great process.
Anthony, just a kind of a side-like question because it got some attention. You announced on Instagram last night. Can you take us through thinking you're going to wear number 23 this year and now you're going to be wearing number 3?
Yeah. That was pretty hurtful, to be honest. They sent me a list of numbers, and I didn't know what to choose. None of them looked right, so went on like 2K and like put all the numbers on my name. obviously, we have rules, and, the rule is, I think by March, whatever, 15th or something like that, that you have to make a request to change a number. So it is what it is, but the first number that I ever wore was number 3, and I put another picture on Instagram today of me wearing that number when I was like in 7th grade. So when I saw the number was available, kind of just wanted to take it all the way back to where it first started and put that number back on.
Anthony, I was wondering, your teammates again with DeMarcus Cousins, and he was saying the other day that you guys never wanted that to end when you did get to play together. What did you learn about him being his teammate the last time you were?
Obviously, before he came to New Orleans, I knew him off the floor, very well, and then on the floor, all the media attention he got for being, emotional. I didn't really see that. You know, me and him are really close, and you know, I kind of told him before, like, you know, we got one goal. You know, so it kind of, he understood. You know, and I think, you know, when, you know, you're in a situation like this, and obviously last year, I mean, it was rarely talked about him being emotional. And when you come to another situation like this, I don't think it's going to be a problem at all, because we have one goal, and that's to win. And I loved playing with DeMarcus. Obviously, we didn't want it to end, but obviously he had to move on and do what's best for him and his family. And now we got the opportunity to, you know, reunite in a great situation. So I'm excited about that.
So those of us on the TV and radio side, we talk a lot about the player empowerment era. Do you have a sense of where your role is now in this decision, this idea of player empowerment and deciding your own destiny?
I just wanted to take control of my career. It was always, you know, people kind of telling me, no, we need to do this, we need to do that, you need to do this. And I just kind of like go with it. You know, I was, you know, young, and I was like, okay, you know, I feel like this person has the best interest for me, whatever. And then as I started getting older, started getting more experience, I was like, I don't want to do that. You know, I want to do it this way. And as long as I can, you know, sleep at night, you know, and live with the decision that I made, then, you know, I'm happy and I don't really care what no one else thinks. You know, I have a great team around me who I can talk to about, you know, things that's going on, and they give me great advice. And at the end of the day, you know, I live with the decision I make.
Hey, Anthony, just thinking about the way.
I like playing the four. I'm not even going to sugarcoat it. I like playing the four. I don't really like playing the five. But if it comes down to it, Coach, and you need me to play the five, then I'll play the five. But like I said, it's the game has become so positionless that, you know, you can put five guys on the floor and then they just play. You know, obviously you guys seen the thing that came out about LJ running a point. Super tall, you know, it's a super tall point guard. So you never, it really doesn't matter. You know, just put five guys out there that fits best with each other and go out there and win.
I'll just add to that too. When Anthony and I first started talking about the roster, he did say, you know, hey, I'd love to have some fives that can bang with some length. And he's 26. We want a decade of dominance out of him here, right? So we got to do what's best for his body, and having him bang against the biggest centers in the West every night is not what's best for his body or for our team or the franchise. So that's why we were so excited when we got commitments from JaVale McGee, who just with his size and length, I mean, him playing at the four and JaVale at the five, that length is extraordinary. And then DeMarcus making a commitment to come here. Again, just he complimented and played so well with AD in New Orleans. And you can just tell he's made a commitment to his body and just having a huge year. So I said yesterday, I think, you know, Boogie's one of the X factors for us. But we wanted to make sure to honor what Anthony asked for when we traded for him, is to get some fives that he could play with.
Frank, over here.
Yep.
You have a deep roster and a very big team. Have you been able to decide who's going to start and how big your rotation will be?
I have some ideas, but nothing's been decided yet. You know, it's way too early for that. We've got a lot of staff meetings that we're going to have. We're going to study a lot of tape. We'll see how guys play together in training camp, and you know, that'll all play itself out. I think it's difficult when you don't have enough good players. But when you have too many good players, that's called a good problem. Yeah.
Anthony, Dan Wecky with the Los Angeles Times. You mentioned kind of the conversations you had with Rob. What are the, outside of LeBron, what are the right kind of players to put around you that optimize what you do most when you have these kind of conversations? You mentioned the bigs. What do you want out of players, out of teammates?
There's guys who just want to win. No egos, you know, guys who just all in with the team. Obviously, one of the things that we talked about, you know, was the bigs and also a lot of shooters. Just knowing that, you know, a guy's going to be coming defensively, double-teaming, triple-teaming, whatever. And now they have to be hesitant about that when you have shooters on the floor. And then on the defensive end, you know, obviously, you know, I think I can guard anybody, but like Rob said, you know, we want to be smart about the situation too. It's a long season, so having guys like JaVale and DeMarcus alongside me in the front court was definitely a thing that we needed to attack as well.
Yeah, Anthony Ohm again. Was wondering, with the way the league is heading, teams and medical staffs and players are very concerned about their health, and load management has kind of become this thing. I was wondering, what do you think as a young star about load management, and how do you think it will apply to you?
I'm playing. I'm 26 years old, and I love the game of basketball. I'm ready to play.
Anthony Shahan, I'm at NBC Los Angeles. What's been your impression of the fans and the city since you've come here, and what's been the reaction? And also, whether or not it's true, the impression was that you wanted to come to Los Angeles in particular. What played into that?
I haven't had much interactions with the fan, but I know when the trade first happened, they put a mural up of me, so I thought that was pretty cool. And then they had some fans outside when I pulled up. But anytime, you know, the Lakers go, you know, came to New Orleans, it was like New Orleans fans, but it was all Lakers, you know. So I know their fan base is, you know, pretty, you know, crazy, and they travel heavy. So I'm excited about that. And, you know, the only thing that I can't get used to is this traffic. It's like unbelievable. But other than that, everything, I love LA. I live here in the summertime, so this was definitely, you know, a place that I'm familiar with, and like I said, I'm excited to get the season started.
So just to close before we get the jersey shot with Allison, I think the thing that the front office is most proud of is, you know, with our two superstars in LeBron and AD, they're both incredibly selfless people that are all about the team and team first mentality. And I remember the first day that Anthony came into the facility, you know, Jeannie and I, we were, you know, talking about how grateful he was. He was just walking around looking at this amazing facility, the showers, where the players eat. And you could just see his appreciation and his gratitude for a place like this. And that's what we want to be identified as, is just a team first mindset, mentality, guys that sacrifice for the betterment of the team, guys that are grateful and appreciate things in life. And we think LeBron and AD and the rest of the roster really stand for that. So.